Good everyone! In previous tutorial, you already know how to record screen as video. Therefore, today I will give you tips and tricks how to edit screen recording like a pro. Before we go ahead, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for new updates from us. By the end of today's video, you will learn how to edit the timing, edit cursor effects, add annotations, and apply green screen effect. Before moving ahead, here are some notes that you need to remember. You will see a recording component in here. It will include a webcam, system audio, audio from a microphone, and video is a separate object, and it will show in a different layer. And you can see here, the system audio is the audio from your computer speakers. And the audio here is the audio when you record your own voice from microphone. So here the first tip for you. When you want to see video frames, when editing, choose the video, then right click, select show video frames. And if you see this make you annoyed when editing, just untick it. Now coming to part 2, edit the timing. And you will see the playhead in Active Presenter here is quite strange at first, but I'm pretty sure it will be convenient for use later on. The playhead shows the current timestamp of the object placed on the canvas, and that is, it will have the green start marker and a yellow end marker here. In this stage, you already select a range here. So this cut range, copy range, delete range, and crop to range are enabled. If you don't choose a range, those commands are not enabled. And now coming to tip 2, range and object. If you select a range without selecting any object, for example, I choose a range here. So if I cut it, it will automatically delete all objects inside, including voice and video. Remember to choose the object when you want to customize. So beside cut, crop, delete, and copy, you are able to insert time, split and enjoy audio or video objects, change playback speed, insert blur area, adjust volume, fade audio in or out, reduce audio noise, and normalize audio. It means you will normalize your audio to the same volume level. Now for tip 3. Zoom in, zoom out timeline, and you can hold Ctrl for window here or Command for macOS while scrolling the mouse up or down to adjust, and right click the waveform bar height in the timeline and select medium or large. Coming to part 3, edit cursor effects. By default, the cursor effect option is off. When editing, you can edit the cursor effect for highlight, click cells, and click effect cures. You can see here, I can change the mouse click like this. I select the video, navigate the mouse to the property pane on the right hand side, and customize cursor effects. After that, I can change the cursor highlight to yellow, add mouse click effects, and so on here. Coming to part 4, add annotations. Annotation here include shapes, text caption, spot highlight, zoom in pan, and closed captions. They can be customized based on your preference. For example, I will demo zoom and pan feature here. I navigate to the insert tab, then choose zoom and pan. You can drag it to the zoom size you wish, and back to the standard side very easily. Now coming to the last one, green screen effect. In other video editors, the green screen has another name, the chroma key. When you want to remove the background of a webcam video that was placed in the corner of tutorial 1, this can be very useful. It can be done like this. You navigate to the right side, choose Media in the property panes, and select Eyedropper. select color to key out here, then drag along the tolerance to the extent you prefer. That's it.
Voila, we are done. I hope with this tip and trick provided today, you can get familiar with editing in ActivePresenter. Do you have any other useful tip when editing too? Comment below to let us know. One last thing, don't forget to download ActivePresenter for free in the description box to try on your own. Now, goodbye and see you in the next video.